We've made it to mission number 10. This is Necrovault. There are only 13 collectibles here. Of course, I'll show you the extra lives and the two secret encounters. Since there's only 13, one would get the sense that perhaps maybe we're winding this thing down. All right, so the first one right off the bat, as you're heading towards the front gate at the beginning, you're supposed to go off to the right, but instead you're gonna go over to the left and find the crystal. All right, so go back the other way, and before you drop down this pit, jump over to the back corner. Now we have an extra life. I'm on the other side of that gate. We've completed this encounter here, and now you gotta stand on these little green circles to open this big, gigantic door, which opens quite slowly. Once this little cutscene is over, we are actually going to avoid going down there and hop on these poles, and we're gonna get up very, very, very high. There are actually two things we're gonna get here. First of which is the extra life. So we're gonna, on this last pole, you're gonna have to double jump, dash over to this wall. It's a very narrow wall, and then jump into the next window, or the window that's next to it. And that is the extra life. Now we're gonna drop down a hole that's just to my right, and pick up the toy. Now you feel free to go through the double doors, jump down the big gigantic hole, do this encounter in this area, and then once it's complete, we're gonna make our way up, we're gonna climb, and instead of going left, you wanna go right. Actually, I don't even think you can go left, but you can go straight, so go right. All right, so next up, we're gonna have a mastery token. So this is the left path, I guess there is a left, and we are going to go into this room with the trap in it that comes down from the ceiling. After you complete it, the mastery token will be available. Use that spot, by the way, if you want to complete the mission challenge for crushing people with the environment. All right, so next up is a Praetor suit point. So from that previous location, just go into the next room, talk to this dude here, pick up his money. Looks like a coin. All right, so from that spot, we're actually going to do a little maneuver. This is a little tricky to find. We're going to go over the nearby ledge, and we're gonna jump, hop, and then kinda turn backwards into the hole, and boy did I almost screw that up. So there's a secret encounter here, it's very easy, but it is a very narrow passageway, so be mindful of that. Maybe not the best idea to use the rocket launcher in close quarters, but nonetheless, secret encounter is complete. Now continue going through this little route where the secret encounter was, and we're gonna come out the other side. So you're going in one way, coming out the other. Jump up here and you'll be right at the base of a toy. All right, next up is an extra life, number two. You're gonna move on, you're gonna do an encounter, and then you're gonna have to double back to this wall here. Now this is part of the story path, so don't worry if you can't find the location. Always just go towards the next objective. So now, once you get up here, just immediately take this hallway, and it'll lead you right to the extra life. All right, so now I am underneath a couple things here, and I'm climbing up. I'm coming up out of this lift to this new area. This thing opens up, and there's a wall you can break open. There's two collectibles, not one, but two. So there's a toy and then a mastery token. All right, continue on your way through those little crushing things to get to the other side. Open up the gate that's in the next room, and then you're going to be in the section I'm at now. There are two collectibles we're going to get here. One is a codec at the end of the, or codex at the end of this. Now we are actually going to go below us, and you can see there's a question mark there. In order to get down there, you're going to have to look for those little blocks that come up, and then jump underneath it. Jump down and around, you gotta be underneath it. And be quick. You may have to dash out of there in time. But there is the cheat code for famine mode. Okay, so now I'm gonna go to the second door switch in this area that you need to activate. Once I've done that, I'm gonna head back to the starting area of this portion. So that's through the two original crushers, broken walls there to the left, and now the secret encounter is now available to you. So this is the second one. There's only two. Not too difficult. I'm just going to use the BFG for the sake of time. Apparently one shot wasn't enough. There we go. Secret encounter completed. So let's move on to the record. The secret encounter also holds a collectible behind it. So just go back to where the secret encounter was and you'll find the record, which takes you right back to where the first gate was. All right, so this is the final area of the game. I'm at the very back of the last arena, and I'm going to swing back towards the front where you enter this, but up high and to the right to grab this one up. After you grab it, stay up here, don't drop down, because we are going to swing over to the opposite side here in front of me. You can see the little gray strip of land there that I haven't uncovered. Well, that is where we're going. So hop over to the center, all the way out. Now watch for these crushing things. Watch for the flames, a whole bunch of things here to try to kill you. As long as you get to the end without dying, you'll pick up the final collectible. And that'll do it for the Necroball mission.